Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna tell you why you need to save early and save often when creating content in Synapse Studio. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all the videos from both Adam and this guy. I was building some content in Synapse Studio for a session that I'll be delivering at a conference that's coming up here in Atlanta called Azure Data Saturday. It'll probably be passed by the time this video comes out. Anyway, it's like house in an hour, and I was building some content in Synapse Studio and I lost it all because I didn't save early and save often. All right, so you guys know what I like to do. Enough of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Okay, I'm over here in Synapse Studio, and let me kind of demonstrate what I was doing. I went here and I created some link services, Synapse Studio, and then I went over here and I created some integration data sets, 3 to be exact. And then I went over here, created some notebooks. Look at all this code I wrote. Look at this, look at that. And then I created another notebook. And then I created a pipeline to grab some data. And as I was creating that pipeline, I was like, oh, wait, I need to save. But when I tried to save, there was some validation that happened. And it said, oh, you need to finish this before you can save. So I was like, all right. I kept working and I said, oh, let me create one more notebook. So I went here, I created a new notebook. And you'll see right here, it says publish. And this is an indication, hey, you need to save. But I ignored it. So I write in my notebook, I had finished the pipeline. And then something happened. It was like my browser locked up and I just went to Task Manager and killed it. And when I went back to Synapse Studio, everything that I created was gone. And I was like, no! I had to start over from scratch. So I learned you need to save early and save often. But when you're creating pipelines, that's a challenge because it's always trying to validate that everything is complete with your pipeline. But if you do some integration with DevOps or Git, you can do a partial save. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So if you go here and start creating a pipeline, you would create your new pipeline. You can drag some activities there. And then what you can do is if you want to do partial saves, and I mean a save that won't have to go and validate everything, you can go here and you can set up your Git repository. Yes, we're gonna discard those changes because I don't care about those right now. And you can choose what you want. So you can use Azure DevOps, Git, or GitHub. And once you get it configured, then you can do partial saves of pipelines that are not completely validated. And if you add a new item, like if I go here and add a notebook, that doesn't require any validation. So you'll see my notebook too. And then I can go and start typing some stuff right here in my notebook, %SQL. I can make a data frame. I can do whatever I want. And then I go right here and I choose publish. It's actually gonna save it out. And when I return back to that repository, it'll be there and I can use it and I don't have to worry about losing everything. So either save often, and when I say save, I mean publish in Synapse Studio. Save early, save often. And if you wanna do partial saves, you would integrate Git or Azure DevOps Git with your Synapse Studio, and you can do partial saves without completing your pipeline. All right, what do you think? Have you run into any challenges like this before? Have you encountered losing all your stuff in Synapse Studio before? I'd love to know. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the Guy in the Cube channel, hit that subscribe button, like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Do, do, do.